compared to all the new stuff that's been coming out, gimmicks and new technologies they claim. They've always been around. We know what works, what kills on contact. You know, but there's a heat treatment. That's a big thing because it's a big show. People come with trailers. They have expensive equipment and fans and heat generators. Looks like something from Service Pro, you know, coming in, you know, for flood damage or fire damage or something like that. They come in with this big crew. It's a big show, you know. And we're going to set up all these furnaces and, you know, tip your furniture over, really bag up everything, and then do a blast furnace job in your house, and just your house can't handle upwards of 140, 160 degrees temperature. Just think about it. Like, a lot of materials nowadays are fabricated and recycled materials. They're not as durable. Wallpaper and the strength of glass is tempered. It's not designed to have. It's designed to keep heat out. You know, not, you know, your house isn't really designed. Contemporary homes nowadays with electronics and everything, the way things are just cheaply made and varnishes, just aren't able to hold up to, you know, this type of hazardous method of what they consider treatment, bed bugs. And then after all said and done, if they missed even one, two bed bugs that happened to be in the wall that the heat didn't penetrate, of course the heat won't penetrate sheetrock, you know, then they'll just keep coming out, and then you have no, nothing's going to keep killing the bed bugs. You know, you spent like $2,000. It's like, I think the average thing is about $2 to $4 a square foot for heat treatments if you call around these companies and claim they're legitimate. But most of these companies, not most of them, but a lot of these heat treatment companies aren't even licensed pest management professionals. They don't have licenses with the state, you know, Department of Environmental Protection. They're just contractors coming in and doing a non-pesticide method of control and then taking advantage of the lucrative bed bug market by, you know, charging like their fees. And they're just contractors coming in with their crew and acting like they're pest professionals, but they don't have, you know, they don't have the thousands of hours of experience like me, 20 years, and we're talking upwards of 30,000 plus hours of field doing the work. And you only heard about heat treatment in the past year and a half or so. And it's just too expensive. It's not proven. It's just one of those new things that they say come in. Oh, we can do this. We have the new technology here with the heat treatment. That's been around. We'll discuss why heat is important, but not to heat your house. There's another method called steam treatment. We've lost jobs because people prefer steam. Because they hear all pesticides, I'd rather use steam because that's fresh, and it's like they think of stainless steamer coming in and steam, you know, cleaning your carpet and sanitizing everything. They use the keyword sanitize. That really perks people's attention. That's a sell word. It's a marketing tactic. I want to come in, instead of using pesticides, we're going to use something natural. It's like hot water, and it's going to come out. And it's just, you're going to direct it to, you know, think about it though, it's water, it's moisture. And what are you going to apply moisture? Where can you apply moisture safely in a home? And, you know, you put it on your mattress, you steam clean your mattress like it's an iron, but you're putting a lot of droplets of moisture. You're pressing this device, it comes out, and it's, you know, it's really putting a lot of steam water onto the fabrics, and only 220 degrees is only going to kill the bed bugs on contact. But what about the bed bugs that are hiding in the structure, the furniture, under the carpets, behind the walls, the baseboards, behind the moldings, behind the casings of the door trim, behind the outlet switch plate covers, conduits, where your electrical wiring goes, your recessed lighting, trim and around your windows. What about the curtain rods? You know, the hollow curtain rods. What's the steam going to do in this situation? It's not going to be able to penetrate all these cracks and crevices. Your furniture, you know, like your dressers, drawers, and stuff like that. They're not designed to take moisture on. You know, if you leave any. That's why it's not outdoor furniture. It's indoor furniture. You get any moisture on anything that's like wood, it's going to absorb that moisture and get damaged. You wouldn't want to take any chances doing that. And also there's another method called the cryonite that's a freezing machine. It's the same kind of concept as steam, very limited, and it's going to leave excessive moisture. And there's so many aspects why a non-pesticide method are very limited and it could do more damage to your home. Here's some benefits of pesticides that don't compare with any other heat or freezing or steam. The treatment dries quickly. I mean, we're talking 2 hours after the treatment because it's even distribution of products by the label. You have to just do crack and crevice in some areas. You could do a broad band, but it's very light. But you're hitting everything very thoroughly. And it's going to stick. It's going to bond to the surface as a property of pesticides. It's not like water. It's like it bonds to the surface. It dries quickly and invisibly and doesn't leave any odor. Residue is microencapsulated for some of these products. So you can come back in 2 hours later and you can start unpacking. If you do a very thorough treatment, you can start putting your furniture back together, make your bed, you know, go back to your business. It's pretty amazing. I mean, that's the experience I've had in 3 straight years. Where some other companies will say, well, the pesticide treatment, you need 4-hour, 6-hour reentry time. That's just something that they say. We know you can reenter the home and reenter and start putting things back in 2 hours. There's no chance of mildew or mold growth with pesticides because of the light application, the light thin application, where steam and freezing, that leaves a lot of moisture. And it doesn't dry, you know, if it doesn't dry within like 4 or 5 hours, all of a sudden you can get mold growing. Especially when there's furniture and stuff that's in floor contact with the floor. Or when your bed is in contact with the bed frame, it's not gonna dry properly. And then you're gonna get mold. And you don't want that. That's even worse. It's a hazard. I mean, trust me, you keep things in storage that's not climate controlled. You ever keep furniture or clothing that you come back in and it's got mold, can have like the white fungus mold. Or the black mold. I mean, you don't want that. Pesticides go much quicker. The prep for and the treat, and it's that passes savings on to you. So our prices for professional treatment is in the middle of the road. It's not the cheapest, but it's not the most expensive. It's the middle of the road treatment, and it's easier, it's quicker, it's just all around. It's just has much value. It's safe for carpets and fabrics. I mean, you wouldn't spray the bed itself, you wouldn't spray the comforters, but I mean, for stuff like couches and throw pillows, you know, if you could spray cracks and crevices, the carpets, of course, it's safe. It's not going to do any damage. You know, most carpets, I mean, wool, I mean, you might take some precaution with that, but you wouldn't steam it either if it wasn't safe with water. But most rugs and things are water resistant. Pesticides are safe for, you know, electronics and computers. You're not, you know, you can't even touch electronics, anything electronics with the pesticides. Come in wet and dry formulations, by the way. That's what I was getting at, where you can inject dry pesticide and lightly apply them. That's why you need a professional to do it properly. Can put them in the switch plate covers of your switches and your outlet covers. You'd like to have a professional do that, wouldn't you? Because that's open to your electric. You know, would rather have somebody who's licensed and insured to do that kind of work. And you could treat certain things like smoke detectors, clock radios, and the motor housings of microwaves, where you couldn't use steam or freezing treatments for that. You couldn't get any kind of moisture in electronics. Stain and varnishes, pesticides, you're just slightly touching it, putting a light application, but you know it doesn't. But steam would like melt it, take the varnish right off, you know, destroy your furniture. You don't want that. Let me see. And guess what? Pesticides is the only thing that leaves a residual that lasts. It depends on what you select. Can last from 2 to 3 months. Sometimes upwards of 4 to 5 months, depending on what kind of formulation you're using, what kind of mixture you're using. If you're using a growth regulator, that gives you definitely 90 days. The bed bugs will keep dying Even if you reintroduce the bed bugs, I mean, you got bed bugs in the first place that could be coming from an outdoor source, which we inform you with the post-treatment instruction guide on how to be vigilant and how to be on the lookout for bed bug activity and ask your friends. You have to communicate, find out how you got them. Maybe your children brought them in from camp or from school or from a book bag, or maybe you got something from a garage sale. You have to be vigilant and know what to look for. But if you happen to reintroduce bed bugs to your environment, it's got a full treatment, a residual waiting for them. And they have nowhere to hide. Or if you did steam or heat or freezing, which are only contact killers, you introduce a bed bug in the next day, you're infested. You can get infested within a couple of weeks. And then you have nothing to help you. You have to start all over again. You pay like twice, you pay just as much for nothing, really. Just for the word safe, because you're sold onto the word safe, really. That's when you found out you've been had after the fact. You get that, a lot of people get that remorse after they hired the company because they didn't really educate themselves and ask questions. They didn't really know what questions to ask. So they just trusted the professional who claimed they were the master of their trade. You just put in your mind that that's what you want. They told you what you want to hear. That's the art of sales, high pressure sales tactics. So that's why I like to put something together for the public to help them make a better decision.